Good morning, Lincoln Lions. This is Mr. Conan. This is your daily announcements for Tuesday, March 12, 2020. Every day, we start with the pledge. So please stand for the pledge. 3, 2, 1.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Next, we hop right into our Lincoln Spirit. Lincoln Spirit on 3. 1, 2, 3. Lincoln Spirit makes us proud, respectful lions above the crowd. Our spirit makes us try our best and challenges us to encourage the rest. Announcements for today. Students, continue to ask teachers questions. I know you might have questions on our packets. We're turning them in on Thursday. Yes, this Thursday we have packet pickup, packet drop-off, and locker and desk item pickup on Thursday, also from 8 to 3 o'clock. So even if you're online, we need your parents and you to come on Thursday during the day to come get all of your items. We have it bagged for you and we'll hand it out. So please come Thursday. That means everybody comes on Thursday. We'll hand all the stuff back to you. Teachers, there's a couple of new packets that are on the table today from being unquarantined. And they'll be on the table. I'll try to take a picture and let you see which classrooms have more stuff. We will have a brief full staff meeting Friday at 12:30. That's different. In the past, we've had it at 1. We're going to have it at 12:30. I have a principal meeting at 1 o'clock on this Friday. So thanks for being flexible. All right, a new section that we have called a talent show update. We'll be conducting a virtual talent show online. We're asking all 3rd through 6th graders that have a talent to video it and send it in for a submission. You may submit your special talent between May 11th, which is yesterday, and going all the way to May 21st by 4 o'clock. Ms. Gordillo and her fantastic talent team will then choose from the video submissions to create this year's Lincoln Lion Talent Show. There are 3 ways you can submit your video: email, Facebook Messenger, or Google Drive by sharing it. You may submit to either Ms. Gordillo or myself. And our contact information is the following. So if you have a pen, please write it down. Talent show submission, email or share on Google Drive to terry_gordillo@gfps.k12.mt.us or to myself, john_conan@gfps.k12.mt.us. We think the most 3 compatible formats for you to use are a YouTube link, a .mov file, which is typically a iPhone, or most all other ones are MP4s. So that's .mp4. Those 3 video types will help us to create our video. So again, here is our talent show submission, who you submitted to, either Ms. Gordillo or myself. You have until May 21st. Yes, till May 21st. 10 days away, 9 days now. All right, next section is heading into our parenting tip strategies and self-care. So today's parenting tip comes from Miss Mary. She works for AWARE and is our CSCT therapist. She talks about coping with anxiety. One strategy that you can use is managing your own stress. This is something I need to do all the time. So managing your own stress. Be a role model for your children. Manage your own stress. Take breaks, eat healthy food, exercise. And when you feel afraid or anxious, do something to calm your body, like deep breathing, listening to calming music, or doing a fun activity. Thanks, Miss Mary. I know personally, I've been using the calming app on my phone to help manage stress lately. Next section is our positive warrior. John Gordon, a well-known motivational speaker and author, talks about being positive, not because life is easy, but because life is hard. I believe we must continue to find the positives, not only at home, but outside the walls of our house. Today, we have a theme throughout the whole rest of the day. It is going with the Sadonis brothers. They talked about flipping our perspective, and they talked about using the words unfortunately and fortunately. So we're going to talk about a negative, and then flipping that perspective to a positive. So, unfortunately, Colin stated that he can't see Mrs. Lund. And fortunately, Rory stated, well, we get to use technology now to communicate, which makes it easier. Both boys stated, unfortunately, we're moving schools next year. Yes, they're leaving Lincoln this year. But fortunately, we get to make new friends. So being able to flip that perspective makes both of you positive warriors. Good job. Please send me, your teacher, or have your parents post on Facebook your positive warrior acts so we can continue to celebrate them on announcements each day. I believe this world needs more positives, so help me be a positive warrior. All right, our book of the day. Each day we'll be reading a story for you from the list of Scholastic books that have been approved. Today I have a fabulous guest reader. We already talked about them, the two brothers, Colin and Rory. They're going to read the story, Fortunately. Remember hearing that? Yeah, that was in our Positive Warrior section. So the story is Fortunately by Remy Sharlip. At the end of the story, we'll be asking some questions that go with it. So thanks, brothers, for being able to do this together. Are you guys ready? Here we go.
Fortunately, written and illustrated by Remy Charlie. Fortunately, one day Nick got a letter that said, please come to a surprise party. But unfortunately, the party was in Florida, and he was in New York. Fortunately, a friend loaned him an airplane. Unfortunately, the motor exploded. Fortunately, there was a parachute in the airplane. Unfortunately, there was a hole in the parachute. Fortunately, there was a haystack on the ground. Unfortunately, there was a pitchfork in the haystack. Fortunately, he missed the pitchfork. Unfortunately, he missed the haystack. Fortunately, he landed in the water. Unfortunately, there were sharks in the water. Fortunately, he could swim. Unfortunately, there were tigers on the land. Fortunately, he could run. Unfortunately, he ran into a deep, dark cave. Fortunately, he could dig. dictionary, he dug himself into a fancy ballroom. Fortunately, there was a surprise party going on and fortunately, the party was for him because fortunately it was his birthday.
Thanks, boys. What a fantastic story that you did for us there. What a great story that you just told for us. It talks about fortunately and unfortunately. And we need to continue to think about when it is fortunate and unfortunate and try to flip the perspective. Good job, guys. So our challenge for you today is, instead of questions, think of something that is unfortunate in your life and try to flip that perspective to being fortunate. And then share that with someone in your house, either a parent or guardian or a brother or sister. So think of something unfortunate, like in the story, and flip that perspective to something that's fortunate. Good job, brothers. So we're looking for more people. In fact, I have readers all the way through Thursday, so I need some more readers coming up. We only have about 20 some days left of school, so we want to keep reading every single day and get some more readers on here. So just like these two brothers, you may share a YouTube link or send an iVideo or share it on Google Drive. All right, each day we end the day with the song of the day. It's a motivational song to get you ready for remote learning. If you'd like to nominate a song for our morning announcements, please email me or talk with your teacher or have your parents write a comment on this Facebook post. Today's song comes from Colin, who wanted you to listen to his favorite song that he plays on the way to school each day by Natasha Bedingfield's, her song, Unwritten. Go be a positive warrior and go Lion Pride.
Still.